Hello students, in this video we see how we can merge two arrays inside a single array, one dimensional array. How we can merge two one dimensional arrays into a third single dimensional array. So I am creating one console application here, and inside this I am creating some 10 arrays A1, then int array A2, and my merged array is A3, one dimensional arrays. Then I am declaring size of first array as N1, second array as N2, and third array as N3. Then I am giving one a message to user as console.write enter number of elements for first array. Enter number of elements for first array. Then user gives me number of elements for first array. Then I need to give the console.read line, but it gives me string, so I need to convert it into int32. So we get the number of elements of first array. Now I need to allocate the memory for exactly n1 elements. So I am allocating memory for A1 array as new int of n1. So this is dynamic memory allocation, exact memory allocation. So in this way we do for second array. Enter number of elements for second array. Now number of elements of for second array I am storing inside n2, and now I am allocating memory for A2 array for storing N2 elements. Okay, N2 number of elements. Now we accept the elements one by one. Now again I am giving one message to user as console.write line enter first array elements. Enter first array elements one by one. So I am using here one for loop for accepting n1 elements. I am using one for loop from 0 to n1 minus 1 for accepting the array elements. I'm using one for loop. I'm giving one message as enter array element. How many times it gives me this message? N1 times. And I need to store elements inside A1, array A1. So I'm using here A1 of I is equal to, user gives me the value and I am storing inside A1. Same I need to do for the second array. Enter second array elements one by one. The length of second array is N2, and I am storing inside second array. So in this way, by using this code, we store the number of elements, n1 elements inside first array. We store n2 number of elements inside second array. Now we need to merge these two array and store merged result inside A3 array. For that, I am using one for loop, and I am using here integer I is equal to 0. And I is less than or equal to n1. we first store first array elements inside merged array, which is A3 of, now I'm using here one variable j is equal to 0, and I'm using that j as an index for A3, and is equal to, I'm storing first array elements. I know inside first array n1 elements are there, so I'm using here 0 to n1. But what is the error? Before assigning the values, we need to allocate the memory for A3. Now how many elements we need to store inside this A3 is merged array, so we need to store first array elements plus second array elements inside this merged array. So how many elements we are storing inside this A3? N1 plus N2. Okay, if in first array there are 5 elements and inside second array there are 7 elements, then inside merged array 5 plus 7 elements are there. So we need to allocate the memory for A3 as new int. How many elements are there inside merged array? Number of elements inside array 1 and number of elements inside array 2. Both elements we need to store inside this merged array. So I'm allocating the memory for A3 as new int N1 plus N2. Total number of elements inside merged array are N1 plus N2. Now, by using this for loop, I'm storing first array element inside this merged array. Same way we store second array inside this merged array by using another for loop. Now I'm going from 0 to N2 because the number of elements present inside A2 are N2. So I'm using here A2. Inside this array 1 elements we are storing inside merged array. Inside this for loop we are storing second array elements inside this merged array. Now what is required here, we are initializing j as 0 and we are not updating this j. Inside this for loop only I is updated and j is not updated, so we need to update as j plus plus here, and also inside this for loop we need to update j as like this. Now by using another for, we print that merged array. 0, j is less than or I is less than j. How many elements are present inside this A3? Now j element, or we or you can give as n1 plus n2. This is the size of A3, so we can give the condition like this, and we are printing merged array elements like this right line A3 of I. But before printing, we give the message on console as merged array elements are, and on the second line one by one elements from A3 will be displayed. So this is the program for merging two single dimensional integer array inside one third array. If we run this program, see what we will get. Enter number of elements for first array. If I am giving the size of first array as 5, then enter number of elements for second array. If I am giving as 7, then it gives me message as enter first array elements one by one. Inside first array we need to give 5 elements, so I am giving here 5, 56, then 45, then 23, then 12, then 67. Now it gives me the message as enter second array elements one by one. how many elements we need to give inside second array? 7, because I'm giving here the number of elements inside second array as 7. So I'm giving here 7 elements one by one, as 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So these are my second array elements, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now merged array elements are 56, 45, 23, 12, 67. These elements are from first array, and we are merging this first array and second array elements inside this third array. So these are the elements of first array, these are the elements from second array, and these are the merged array elements. So merging means like a concatenation. First array elements concatenated with second array elements, and we are storing all these inside third array, third merged array. So how many elements present inside this merged array? The number of elements present in first array plus number of elements present in second array. In this output, 5 plus 7 means total 12 elements are here inside merged array. So this is the logic behind merging two arrays inside one single array. If I run again this program, if now I am giving here 2 only and 3, and it gives me the message like this, then inside merged array there are only 5 elements, because inside first array there are only 2 elements, inside second array there are only 3 elements. So inside merged array total 5 elements present. First 2 elements are from first array, second 3 next 3 elements are from a second array. So this is the logic behind merging of two arrays inside one single array. So this is the program. Here we declare three arrays, then declare size of each array n1 n2 n3, and j one single variable we initialize as 0. Then inside this we get the number of elements from first array, then we allocate the memory for array 1, because user enters n1 elements, so we need to allocate memory, exact memory allocate we here for n1 elements. Similarly we do for the second array, then we get those n1 elements from user one by one and store inside this first array. Similarly we get the number of elements from user and store inside a2 array. Then after that we allocate the memory for merged array as n1 plus n2 number of elements, because inside merged array there are elements equal to n1 plus n2, number of elements equal to n1 plus n2. So we need to allocate the memory for A3 as n1 plus n2 number of elements. Now by using first for loop, we store the first array elements inside this merged array. By using second for loop, we store second array elements inside this merged array. And by using this last for loop, we print the merged array elements. So this is the program. You may try this and see your output.